Lot to talk about today.
Lots going on.
Ooh, as you can see, today is another gloomy day in Gotham City, AKA New Orleans. I'm Wild Wayne from iHeartMedia and also from the New Orleans Pelicans and a proud New Orleanian. Today, I have the head of the Behavioral Health Department here at UMC, Ms. Denise Duga. Did I pronounce it properly?
Yes, Cajun
Duga. Cajun.
Yeah. And thanks for having me.
No
and
doubt.
We're going to talk about a very important topic this time of the year.
So I have had relatives that have been under your watch and have done great things when they left here. So congratulations to all the good work that you're doing with the patients that need so much help out there.
You're welcome.
Today, we're talking about seasonal depression. You know, you have these gloomy days sometimes, and then after we have daylight saving time, things kind of change a little bit. And folks are dealing with some other things, and sometimes they'll just brush it off. Oh, it's nothing. But it is, in fact, the thing.
It's a disorder. Seasonal affective disorder is a disorder where when the season changes, the days get shorter, the moon's out really quick, 5:30, 6 o'clock. People have episodes of melancholy and depression, and it is a disorder that people have. We all feel some melancholy when the season changes, right? Because you have to change your routine. Me, for example, I like to walk every evening outside. But now that the days are short, I get home after dark. So I had to change my routine and start using a treadmill.
Mm-hmm.
I hate treadmills.
Right.
But I didn't want to give up my exercise. So I kind of felt a little depressed about it. But, you know, I had to cope with it. And it's like, what can I do to make my treadmill exercise more enjoyable?
Right.
So I download an Audible book, listen to it, and it gets me through that workout. So some of us can cope. Some have a more difficult time.
Okay.
If they know it's coming 6 to 8 weeks before the season changes, start making preparations. Get with your doctor. Get on antidepressants if they help to get you through that season. Take on new hobbies that don't involve sunlight. Start changing your routines early before you have to. Change your lighting in your house to make it more bright. Take vitamin D.
Because we know that the sun actually helps your body produce vitamin D. So it's something that's actually lacking. So you may have to fill it with another alternative
being a vitamin. So there are a lot of things that you can do to help you get through that bump.
So is it something chemically that happens inside a person's body that makes these things change? Or is it the body clock being off a little bit?
It's probably a combination of different things. The body clock, or some people just enjoy long days, lots of sun.
Right.
They do a lot of activity outside and then they feel like they have to give all that up because the days are short. Could be vitamin D deficiencies. It's a number of things. And a physician, primary care, or psychiatrist can help you figure out what are the best things to get through that.
Now, I read also about seasonal depression that sometimes it makes you change your eating habits even, makes you crave wanting to eat more food and be a little more sedentary.
Comfort food.
Right.
You tend to snack more because you're less active. Some people may drink a little bit more, you know, start drinking a little earlier in the evening than just having that one glass of wine. You may have two. So you have to know that you have it, accept it, and then before the season starts changing, start with new habits are healthy.
Is there a way that you can diagnose it yourself and differentiate it from just having a bad day versus something that you know there's something more going on within your brain or within your body? Is that something you can diagnose on yourself, or do you need professional advice or help?
It's one of the most self-diagnosed disorders.
Okay.
People learn, oh, every season I get this way. And if it's severe and you can't cope, then yes, definitely go see a psychiatrist or your primary care physician. Like me, like I said, I do feel a little more melancholy and a little more gloomy because the days are short. I know it. I've self-diagnosed myself, but I have overcome it with just trying different things through the years.
No doubt. So I think that's important to let our listeners, our viewers out there know. Once you kind of have it diagnosed, let's kind of recap what are those things that they can do to make sure moving forward they could kind of insulate themselves from that depression from this seasonal part of the year. So you said maybe getting out and exercising a little bit more, maybe changing some of their eating habits. And what are some other things that they should maybe do? Maybe don't try to drink three drinks when you should only be drinking one. What are some of those things?
Always make sure you get enough rest.
Okay.
Definitely. And do things that are healthy, stay hydrated. And if medication helps, because it takes 6 to 8 weeks for like antidepressants to get that therapeutic value in your body, mm-hmm. start taking them before the season changes. Get new hobbies with your friends, get together, mm-hmm. have a book club, work on puzzles instead of doing outside activities at the park because it's dark. Plan to do your outside activities on the weekends when daylight's out there, mm-hmm. so you're not totally giving that up. There's a lot of different things that you can do. Mm-hmm. There's not one answer for one person.
Right, right.
It's what's enjoyable for you, how you can time manage and rearrange your schedule and not give up on yourself, mm-hmm. and things that you enjoy doing.
Yep. And I think it's really important that we have this awareness out there. And that's the main goal of Vital Signs, to let folks know what's going on out there. And sometimes you will be able to acknowledge these things and do self-help. Sometimes you may need a little extra help from folks like yourself here at UMC. So thank you for letting folks know about it. I think in our next episode, we're going to talk about some of the things that happen, not only when the seasonal time of the year, the fall and the winter come, but also when the holidays come. Because that's a whole nother bag of tricks there, a whole nother set of things that really puts people sometimes in a dark place.
Yes.
So the holiday blues, but we'll talk about that when we come back. Thank you so much. We have Ms. Denise Duga, the head of behavioral health here at UMC.
Thank you for having me.
No problem.